Hi guys and welcome back to the part 24 of my F1 manager creator team. Obviously we are not in our own team, but guys, this is our redemption season. So this is a chance to prove to our team that we can do it and go back into our own team for the next season. So we are just looking at that. Obviously we have done manufacture underfloor and we are going to manufacture a rear wing, because obviously having extra parts always helps, which I think we learned from the last season to always have at least one extra part. But look at that, we are looking at the design. Obviously we have 4.6 million in the name here, but look at that guys, monthly car development, it's not looking good though. But we obviously have some upgrades here which we will put on the car and we will see what we can do there. Obviously we have a training schedule which is as always a normal thing, we do not want to change anything here. And we have a front wing design upgrade here, so let's put it into manufacturing and bring it for this race, which I don't think we will be able to do because the Japanese Grand Prix is in 2 days and it takes 3 days to manufacture a front wing. So I think we will be able to do one. And we have obviously done our sponsor plan in which we only get 600,000, so it's not too much money, but let's just do the sponsor plan. Obviously I do as much extra as we can so we can save that for the end of the season. So guys, let's just go on to the race targets. 9th for Lewis Hamilton, which was 10th, but and let's get into the qualifying.
Hello and welcome to the much anticipated qualifying session.
Suzuka is a notorious circuit, both for its unpredictable weather and the difficulty of closely following other cars. Making the right call on when to head out to avoid traffic and dirty air can make all the difference here.
And of course, there's the Williams driver. Karun, how do you think they'll fare today?
They set a great lap in practice, so you can only imagine how good they're feeling going into qualifying. But the big question is, will they be able to keep this performance up?
So get yourselves comfortable, it's going to be quite the ride.
So into the qualifying, heavy rain predicted for this. Obviously we are still on inters, and if you can see untested setup for both of them, it's because guys, I am not pushing these guys too much in the practice sessions, which I think I did. That was my biggest mistake, I think, in the last season, is that I did too much laps in practice, and which cost us a lot in the tire wear, in the engine wear too, and in the components wear too. So we are sending our drivers out now at the end of this train, because guys, if you saw on the weather update that the rain is going to be the slightest at the middle of the session. So sending both of our drivers out. Hulkenberg is in the middle of the pack. Hamilton is almost at the end, followed by Ricardo and Russell of Williams. So everyone has started their laps. We are still on the out lap. Hulkenberg is starting his lap with 2.5 mm rain, almost 2.5, which is going down guys. Look at that, it's now 2.4 and it's just going down. So that's a good news, because the people in front of us will remove the water on the racing line and on from the track, and because of that we will be able to do a much better lap here. So I think Hamilton will be able to do a better lap than Hulkenberg. Obviously he's at least 10 cars behind Hulkenberg. So Hulkenberg green sector, Hamilton with a green sector. So let's see, Hulkenberg second sector is also green. Obviously this is their first sectors. So we have the first time coming in, Max Verstappen with a 1:34.0, Piastri with a 0.9 slower, and Hulkenberg is a 1.5 seconds slower. Okay, let's see, can Hamilton do a better lap than Hulkenberg? Obviously he had a much better racetrack than Hulkenberg, and he has proved it with a 6 tenths faster time than Hulkenberg. That obviously getting a better racing condition for the track has proved that he can do better lap. Obviously, now we are going to take these tires and put it back in. So, we are sending both of our drivers again, obviously taking a little extra time. So, starting our final lap for Q1, Hülkenberg has started his lap. Obviously, the problem is that the rain is now increasing, so the time won't be getting any better. So I think this is more or less the grid we have. So we have actually confirmed our position in Q2. This is just, well, not to get done by anyone at the end of the session time, because look at that, guys. Hülkenberg hasn't improved Hamilton, and he hasn't done his first sector. But yeah, look at that, now he hasn't improved. So let's see, can anyone else improve? Albon, Sainz, both of them are improving. Verstappen actually improved. Sargeant is also improving. So people are improving because they are obviously on the new inters. I decided to not go on to the new inters and waste one tire here. Obviously, there might be rain at the next session, so we do not want to waste more inters here because we only get 5 sets. So Hülkenberg hasn't improved, and we have brought Max Verstappen his P1. With a 91 and a 92% setup, I think that's a good amount to get on the setup. We can't change anything. I wanted to, you know, get a better setup there, but obviously, because the front wing is optimal, you can't change much. So let's see. So the best time to go out on the track will be at the end of the session, and we have started at the end here. 30 seconds remaining. We have already started our final lap. Lando Norris in P1, but he is, I think, a little early. Albon, Gasly, these guys have done their laps a little too early. We will get the best track conditions right now. Obviously, it's already on dry. Well, if we had done these sets, well, if we had gone on to dry sets, we might have done a much better lap. But look at that, guys. Everyone else who are in the drop zone has completed their lap. We are the only one who hasn't completed their lap. So Hülkenberg stays to the line. He goes to P4. Hamilton goes to P3. And that's what I'm talking about, guys. This is amazing. And Fernando Alonso and Oscar Piastri and Carlos Sainz out in Q2. I think Alonso is the biggest upset. So we might be able to get some good position here for Q3. So let's see. Going into Q3. Let's see, the rain will increase, so we have to send both of our drivers as fast as we can.
It should be green.
Obviously, there is no rain forecasted for the race, so I think we can use every set of inters so that we can do a much better lap. So Hamilton is starting his first lap. Hülkenberg has started his lap, and both of them has DRS open. Both of them have DRS open, so it's a dry tire, but I don't think anyone else has gone on to, well, dry tires, because obviously, look at that, guys, the rain is getting heavier. It will get heavier after the second sector. Look at that, guys, it has started. The rain has started to get heavier. Obviously, Albon doing a purple sector, but we are also still good enough because obviously Albon is in a Ferrari. We are Ferrari's customer team, and both of our drivers had done a purple sector, and Albon has taken that purple sector, and Charles Leclerc has done the purple first sector. We go out and we are 1-2 right now. Obviously, only our 700s. That was a good lap, and we have ended our session in 7th and 9th. Obviously, I did send them out once at the end because just to not, well, got out by anything extra here. But guys, there was no point because the rain was so heavy, no one could have done anything here. So we will be starting this race in 7th and 9th. Max Verstappen on pole 2. So guys, let's just get into the race.
It won't be long before we get underway here in Japan with 53 figure of 8 laps around this historic circuit.
Anything can happen at Suzuka, as Kimi Raikkonen proved in 2005. The Finn battled all the way from 17th to win. Will we see a similar show of will and talent today, I wonder?
Drivers will battle it out this weekend on the snaking turns of Suzuka, the only figure of eight track in Formula One. High-speed downforce will be the name of the game here, if teams want to secure a place on that podium. Here we are, folks. We're back for another day of scintillating F1 action. It's race day.
So, into the race. See, no rain forecasted, so that's a good sign for us. So, it's going to be a soft mediums because we did not use a single dry tire in the qualifying session. So, guys, let's just go. Into the grid formations.
Welcome back, everyone. The final preparations are now being made as we head into the race. There's a lot of talk about that man, Nico Hülkenberg.
They've done well to secure a P9 start, and they'll be keen to convert that into some points.
And it looks like we're good to go. Get ready. It's the Japanese Grand Prix. And it's lights out, and away we go.
So we start 7th at night. Charles Leclerc trying to make something, but Lando Norris obviously will try to overtake. But look at that, Albon is now trying to overtake here, but Bottas obviously can't do here much, but Hamilton obviously will give his best to overtake Bottas, his old teammate, still for the whole first sector, still going side by side there. Bottas obviously on mediums, we are on softs, and we have overtaken Bottas. That's a good thing for us. Obviously, it will be a good confidence boost for both these guys. But Hülkenberg is still in P9. We are pushing right now because it's the first lap. Obviously, Albon tried to overtake Norris but wasn't able to do in the first sector. But we were able to do. Look at that. Only pushing for the first lap and the tires are overheating a little bit. So, we decided that let's not push these soft tires too much. And we are skipping past the time a little bit, and Hamilton has overtaken Tsunoda too. So let's see the replay. So it was on the back straight. Obviously, both of the Aston Martin are on medium tires, so it's understandable why that happened. And I was obviously Hamilton was using his battery, so it makes sense. And Tsunoda with the help of DRS, as soon as I stopped using battery here, he was able to just caught up to us with the help of DRS, and Hülkenberg has overtaken Bottas. But I think we all know how he has overtaken him, but we are going to still see here. So into the inside, that was an amazing overtake. Obviously Bottas is still on medium tires, so he can't do much here, but he will be faster at the end of the race. But the problem is they are not enough fights. The Aston Martin aren't enough rides, they are much faster, and we have a safety car. We have a virtual safety car, and it's VSC, Paul Anna, VSC. Aaron, our old teammate, well, we our old team driver, which we picked. And now I think we have picked a wrong driver, but he was the only one who was kind enough to accept the contract, and he just spun, went a little too throttle happy and just went into the wall. We have a VSC, obviously we cannot pit here, so at the end of the VSC, going green, and Tsunoda almost losing, well, he almost did lose the DRS here, but Hülkenberg has lost DRS to Tsunoda. Tsunoda obviously pushing now, and our tires, well, they went cold, but they are now back into the working region. So sit rep on lap 11. Hamilton is in P7. Hülkenberg is trying to overtake Ocon from the outside, and he has overtaken for P8. Tsunoda and Bottas has already overtaken us, but obviously their medium tires came back in after 6th or 7th lap, so they were able to overtake us easily. Obviously, I've told you guys, Aston Martin are not in our range. They are much faster than us. So right now the fight is with RB and a little bit with Mercedes. Obviously, I also did not thought that we will be fighting Mercedes. So our main competitor is Mercedes. So lap 16 into the pits with a bad pit stop for Hülkenberg, 4.6 seconds. We are out in P16. Ricardo is in front of us. Sargeant, who has also pit, is behind us. And we are pushing Hamilton too, to bring him into the pits at the end of the lap. And we are pushing Hülkenberg to bring those tires in the working window. So, at the end of lap 17, into the pits, 2.7 pit stop time. That's a good stop. Piastri, Gasly, Ocon, Pocher, Ricardo, everybody else is into the pits. So let's see. And Hülkenberg has overtaken every one of them. Obviously not Piastri, because they are, well, he is better than us. But look at that, Oscar Piastri, with the help of DRS, just flies past Hamilton, obviously. Well, I say obviously a little too much, but obviously it wasn't, well, it was given, and we have a crash. Let's see.
Now we should be able to take a look here.
So Ocon there, and Sauber must be Theo Busch.
Pushing a bit too hard at this point.
And I don't think that was Ocon's mistake. I think Porsche just misjudged the corner a little bit and went a little too wide. But I think they will do a little bit of an investigation, and let's see if they do something in that. But well, Max Verstappen is into the pits, and lap 32. Well, nothing happened in the second part of the race. We are both on mediums, obviously. Sainz is in P10 and Hülkenberg is in P12, but everything will be able, we will be able to complete this and bring these guys into the pits for their last stop. Obviously right now we are still pushing these tires, and we have almost 3 to 4 laps to go. So skipping past a little bit of time, and Hülkenberg has caught up to Ocon, who was, well,
what's that?
With us before the pit stops, is now we have caught up to him, because obviously Hülkenberg lost a lot of time in the pit stops. So let's see, can he, and Sainz has overtaken Hamilton. Obviously Sainz has, well, Mercedes has a good car, but obviously their second driver isn't able to do much. He is a rookie, so obviously it's not needed for him to do too much here. But look at that, guys, he is still in the DRS of Hülkenberg. So can he do something? But before he did something, we brought Hülkenberg into the pits. Let's see, a 2.6 pit stop, that's a good stop for us. Marty obviously has overtaken us, but it doesn't matter, he has to pit. So we come out in P14. Obviously we are going to push Hamilton to bring him into the pits, and on the same, well, very next lap, we have brought Hamilton too. So let's see, can we just stay in front of Porsche? Sainz and Hamilton, well, exchanging position in the pit stop, but that obviously happens sometimes. But and Porsche has overtaken us. Well, we come out behind Porsche. Obviously I did not want to do that, we wanted to come out in the cleaner air, but we will now have to overtake Porsche with Hamilton. Hülkenberg obviously 4 seconds behind, and on lap 41, Hülkenberg is now in P13, and again will overtake, well, with the help of DRS, and well, not using his battery, tried to overtake Ocon, wasn't able to do, but we are just going to stay behind him. And on lap 43, again with the help of DRS, Ocon is defending fearlessly here against Hülkenberg. But Max Verstappen is going to lap us, and because of that we will be slow, Hülkenberg will be slow, and Ocon will also be slow. So can this actually make a chance for Hülkenberg into the hairpin? He tried to look little bit of a dive bomb, but they didn't do it. It was a good decision, because he would have collected Ocon there. So Hamilton P10, Hülkenberg P13. So into 130R, Hülkenberg, we are pushing him to the max here so that he can get close to Ocon and overtake him. And this time, with 10 laps remaining, Hülkenberg has overtaken Ocon. So let's push and catch up to Marty there. Obviously, look at that final lap. Nothing was able to done here. Max Verstappen rounding out the last corners here, and he will obviously win the Japanese GP, because he is in P1 with 21 second gap. Obviously we weren't able to catch up to Sainz with Hamilton, which I think makes sense because he is in a little bit faster Mercedes than us. And look at that, Max Verstappen rounding out the last chicane with 22 seconds gap, winning the Japanese GP for the former engine manufacturers of Honda B with the Hamilton and Nida race in P10. And Charles Leclerc rounding out the last corner, he will be in P2. And Hülkenberg in P12. Obviously, I think that's a good race. At least we score 1 point, but I don't think Hülkenberg, Hamilton, has done his race target. So that might be a little bit difficult, but let's talk about that
after the podium celebrations in Japan.
So Max Verstappen won the race. Fernando Alonso gained 9 positions. That's how fast their car is, guys. That's how fast the Red Bull is. You can't do anything here. But Fernando Alonso and Max Verstappen will be the one fighting for this championship. And because of that, guys, McLaren, who is in P2, is like nowhere to be seen here. And it's going to be a P1 for Red Bull. No problem here. And we have lost 500,000 in this race. So guys, if you're enjoying these videos, please like and subscribe to the channel. And I'll see you on the next one.